Next up, the leaders after the short program from China. We just saw a big number posted from the Germans. Now here is the team who has the best chance at the gold medal, but they're going to have to fight for it. Sui Wenjing and Han Kong. It looks like he forgot which side of the ice they were starting on. It happens.
That most certainly happens. It's just more embarrassing when your partner doesn't forget. Beautiful quadruple twist with such ease. Triple toe, double toe combination. Side by side, triple salve. She doesn't make the rotation, landing forward on the heel. Huge break in the program. Triple Sao Cao, just perfect to be able to come back, respond from the mistake on the jump with the throw of the same type. Just unbelievable. Triple flip, as good as it gets.
Sui Wenjing and Han Kong from China.
Now, if you take a look at the upper left-hand corner, they are the leaders right now. But when they review the landing of that side-by-side triple sow cow, if she gets an under, that score could drop. But remember, they do have the lead, and as we said before, their program components are breathtaking. They're one of the two top program component skaters in the event. It could be very close.
Well, as we hold our breath and await those scores, we have to take a moment to appreciate the brilliance of this couple and what they were able to put together in this free skate. They set the bar high in their short program, rounded it out with a near flawless free skate, although there was that obvious mistake on the side-by-side jump. So we now know that they will need a 149.08 to win the gold medal. And as you mentioned, Ryan, there will be some review there by the technical specialists as they look in slow motion. However, if things remain as we just saw them in the technical score, Sui and Han will be the new world champions. And after everything that we've seen from them this last season, it would be easy to know just how they deserved it.
It's been a long time coming. They have been such an exciting team over the past few years. Every year at the World Championships, they seem like the team to beat, and they have not been able to break through. They have a certain quality that no one else has. They're constantly performing. They look, take a second look at that side-by-side.
I mean, I want to know what you thought, Ryan. Do you think that was under-rotated?
Oh, man, it looked real close. So hopefully it's not under enough for the Chinese team, but it's going to be very close. But as I was saying, just the quality, the power, they're so small in stature, and they disguise it so well by exploding from one element to the next without breaking character. There is so much raw emotion. I feel like a big tear up just watching them hitting their ending pose. It's so special, the connection that they have. They want this so badly, and they just continue to impress year in and year out.
They're two-time world silver medalists already. We said they need a 149.08. Their best score is a 144.28. There it is, 150.83. And even with the deduction, it is enough to overtake the Germans. And the Chinese, Sui and Han, win their first world gold medal in Helsinki.
And what a time to do it. The year before the Olympic Games, getting that momentum. They had the short season because of injury. And wow, they came out, they delivered. It wasn't...